Hello everyone, and welcome back to this season finale of Let's Play Fire Emblem. My name is Manx, and I don't know why, I just wanted to do a little bit of a special intro on that one. Because today I'm going to be attempting to finish this game in this episode. I don't care how long it takes me, but I'm going to do it right now. We are on the final chapter, The Truth of the Legend, and I am really excited about this. Because I've only done this chapter once in my entire life, because the last time I completed this game, like 5 years ago, it's the only time I actually reached the end, so very, very excited to be here, and a little bit of a loss of words, actually, that I've actually managed to do the entire Let's Play up until this point. So, without any further ado, let's find out the truth of the legend, shall we? After defeating Burn's remaining troops, Roy entered the Dragon Temple. He searched for the Dark Priestess to prevent the same tragedy as the Dragon-Human Wars from happening again. Alright. Here in the temple, Roy was to learn the truth of the legend he had always heard. What Roy was about to hear was completely different from what he had always believed to be true. Oh my god. Epic layouts, am I right? Wow, I'm still baffled by how beautiful this level looks. It's a fucking huge ass level. Okay, let's start by having a look at the map. Mamkits. Mamkits, and more Mamkits. Yeah, it's pretty much going to be the enemy of the day. This is the Dragon Temple, after all. I actually would have thought it would be a little bit cooler if they didn't stay in their human forms where they were here, but like instead just walked around as dragons. Would make, you know, sense, but I guess they didn't bother to implement new dragon sprites. So, as we can see, these other parts, like, you have to fight your way through several temples, and the roof is covering them, so we can't see what's inside them. And we can only bring 10 units, and two of those are, of course, predetermined, like Roy and Fa. I don't know why it wants me to bring Fa, but obviously, you know, I have to bring her. Don't really know what happens if she dies. I may have to restart, to be quite honest. But yeah, having Fa alive is actually a requirement to get to this part, so... So I guess we'll be bringing our strongest units then, which actually, come to look of it, it seems like we just have room for all of our preferred units. Yeah, the entire team will actually make it to the roster. I mean, Merlinus. Yeah, let's bring Merlinus. Yeah, Ellen, Klein, Lou, Alan, Echinda, Clarine, Fear, Shin, and Roy. And I've already used quite a few of my legendary weapons, truth be told. As far as I remember, there are no... I'm not sure if there's any, like, Berserk or whatnot here, but... Just to be completely sure, okay, she cannot use Arulilla yet, but let's take a look at Ellen's mastery. It's actually very close, so if we give her a few hits with the Lightning Tome, she should be able to pretty much, you know, use that cool magic that I really want to use. Klein is ready to go. Lou is more than ready to go. Alan is ready to go. Echina's ready. Green is ready. Shin could probably get some better weapons, truth be told. Still only Steel Blade. Huh. You know what, Shin? You're gonna get something from Klein. Klein, give him one of your Silver Bows. Do it. Actually, that's Klein's only Silver Bow. Fine, I guess Shin will use a Short Bow then. Have to be like that. Do we actually have any consumables of any kind? No, we don't. So, what we have is what we get. Roy, your steel swords are still pretty good. I don't want to give you a steel blade because you'll be weighted down. And yeah, I think we'll just go. Pretty much. Have the mounted units in the back so we'll get there the fastest. Fa can really stay behind, truth be told. Yeah, let's do this. Play! Chapter 24, The Truth of the Legend. It's so quiet. This is the Dragon Temple. The air is strange. Do the 8 heroes find under such pressure as well?
Oh, hello, Jan.
Would you stand before us again, humans?
What? Who are you? When did you...
I am Jan. I am the last remaining dragon of the Dragon Temple.
The last dragon? You seem different from the other dragons. Are you the Dark Dragon?
Derp. The dragons you have been fighting, which are war dragons, know nothing but battle. And the Dark Dragon is something completely different from me. I am a full-blooded dragon who fought you humans in the faraway past.
Different? Wasn't the Dark Dragon supposed to be the leader of the dragons?
The Dark Dragon is an object that is meant to bring hope to us dragons again.
Well, excuse me, Jan, but didn't you just mock humans for having hope and, like, will and stuff like that? And you have a fucking thing meant to give you hope?
Oh well. It is no leader.
What? Then what is the Dark Dragon?
It seems you have very much to learn.
Tell us, what is the Dark Dragon?
Well, I have to fully understand my enemy before I fight. Well, I don't think the enemy leader is going to give you intel for that.
Well, I have no reason to tell you. And yet, I have no reason not to tell you. What should I do?
Rock, paper, scissors?
Alright, I shall test you to see if you are worthy of hearing the truth. I am deep inside the temple. Fend off our attacks and come to me. Then I shall explain everything. Just like any good antagonist.
But you're right here! What you're seeing now is just an illusion. If you wish to know the truth, then come to me. If you prove yourself worthy of my time, then you shall hear it all.
Toying with the protagonists. Yep, we got everything here. Alright, dragons, let's go kill them.
Oh, look at that. Ashina has no friends left. They're all dead. That's sad.
We are at the final level.
And we have not leveled far a single time. I don't like using Mamkits. I never like using them. Alright. Okay, they're not moving. I don't think this dragon on the throne is moving either. Why are they so slow? Dragons, that is. They're like 5. They have a movement of 5. It's nothing. Alright, we'll move our units. And yeah, Fa, I guess you can come too. Now, I hope that dragon on the throne doesn't attack. Well, he wasn't. Fear, you'll get the honor of killing the boss dragon with your Durandal. Well, as Elfin said, using divine weapons is indeed the key to killing dragons. Especially when you do 150 damage and when it crits. Okay. And then Etchinda, you will kill this guy. Maybe, let's see if Alan can kill this guy first. Yep, definitely can. Now you guys are kind of screwed, because I got like a whole arsenal of dragon-killing weapons right here. They're about to break, though. So I guess we'll be down to Silver Sword and Killing Edges before the day's true. Let's see, an Ahmad's time. I probably don't need to use my divine weapons at this point, but I just find it so hilariously funny to do a lot of damage. Cool. Okay. And there is the first throne. Now, actually, I think, yeah, you can walk here, but I think you need to conquer the throne in order to unlock the chapter. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna... Actually, Lu can heal as well, so let's have him walk for a little bit. But the other units can... I don't remember. I think there may be reinforcements coming from the back here. But I don't quite remember now. You can pick up your brother. Ellen, you can use your physics. There we go.
Roy, you have your sealed sword, right?
Yeah, you do. I kind of need that.
Right, let's conquer. Yeah, that was the end. Final battle done.
You, are you real this time? Or this is but the entrance. You have a long way to reach me. But you seem strong enough not to die immediately.
Oh, of course.
Let's see. We have gone through many hardships.
So I see.
Very well, I shall tell you a little about the Dark Dragon. The Dark Dragon is not the leader of the dragons as you thought. The Dark Dragon was created to bring us victory.
Created?
So it wasn't the Dark Dragon making more dragons? The dragons you speak of are correctly referred to as war dragons. As I said before, they are different from pure dragons such as I. Indeed, the war dragons are created but by the Dark Dragon. Around the Dark Dragon was created, and the Dark Dragon was created out of the Divine Dragon, the most powerful of our kind.
Created out of the Divine Dragon?
Then the Dark Dragon is actually the Divine Dragon agreed to become the Dark Dragon?
That's a lot of dragon.
Agreed? No. We destroyed its soul so that it would follow our leader's every command.
What?
We desperately needed the power of the Divine Dragon. Our entire species was at stake.
You needed the power of the Divine Dragon? But why did you have to destroy its soul?
Why, you ask? If you want that answer, then seek me out again. I shall witness your power for further.
Dragons are complicated shits.
But did it just... No, it didn't just heal all my guys.
Lou?
Heal, please.
Wow. Yeah, so I guess dragons also do fucked up shit. Giuseppe wasn't right.
Dragons are evil too.
Oh, and again, we have 4 mankits this time. This time with an elixir. Oh, they all have elixirs, actually. Well, I don't count time to bring thieves.
Alan. Go deal with that guy.
Actually, we could give Alan some kills, come to think of it. Actually, Alan should have picked up Roy. Oh yeah, yeah. I was like, hey guys, I'm late. Sorry, I'll make my way to the throne room. It's like, this is the dragon temple, right? Heard you guys throwing a party.
Alright, so we have one dragon who wants to be dead there. Now, oh, actually, I should turn off. This wouldn't be an epic battle if we didn't have animations on everyone. It would be fun to actually give Fa a kill. I know she owns dragons with that.
Wait a minute. She is actually a divine dragon.
That means she's probably the daughter of the dark dragon, maybe? I don't know. Maybe she is.
Ah, we have the Durandal, but I honestly don't think we need it.
Actually, we kind of do. Let's kill it.
Pew, 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 pew.
Machine gun. It would be funny if we just made our way into the dragon temple with machine guns and just shot down everything. Daka, daka, daka. Okay, so we have 4 mankits this time. Dragons' resistance are really crap, actually. Yeah, they get some minor bonuses from their stones, but it's only +5, so they're kind of horrible. It would be funny to actually level up Fa, and she has godlike growths, by the way. Like, really, really good ones. Yeah, I'll pick up Roy. Now the question is, this guy is coming in behind me. I could just go kill him off, I guess.
Four blaze!
The dubstep tone. And down he goes. Man, feels good killing you dragons. Alright, Lou is level 20. Oh, he's level 20. Look at his stats. Look at them. He's darn Imba. That's what he is.
Okay, so I guess... can Clarine take a hit from one of those guys? 40 hit points. This guy does 41 damage. Should be able to. I just need to make sure I don't put her in the range of another guy. Oh wait, what's his crit? This is crit of 16. Clarine has a luck of... enough. So that should be good, actually. Da, 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 da. Yep, let's dump Roy off here. Oh, more of them. Oh my god, I'm not gonna make any more jokes, but I think that may go on for a while. Oh my god, Clarine, you do like no damage at all. It's just like, ow! My nose! Yeah, Clarine, I think you're going back to healer now. Sorry. Your damage just isn't cutting it. Yeah, I want to waste my legendary bow. The worst part is it's probably going to miss. How do their dodge animation look? Well, I guess we'll never know. I think they just raise up their head or something. Klein is level 13. Skill and luck and hit points. And I guess your days as a useful unit is over, Klein. Since you just used up your last bow. However, we still got lots of Durandal for you guys. Especially if she continues to crit like that. Okay. Roy, maybe? No, I'm not gonna use the sealed sword. Now again, white dragons cannot attack at a range still baffles me. The dragon in Fire Emblem 7 did a correct job with that. He was like, well, if I just, you know, breathe fire on them from afar. Let's see. Yeah, I guess Roy can kill this dude with the silver sword now. No, he can't. Need a little bit more help. Come on, javelin. They are very tanky against normal weapons. I'll give them that. Oh, there we see the dodge animation. There's actually a bug where you can steal the Firestone if you berserk a thief. And you can actually use that on Fa to give her like endless uses. Actually, it would be really funny to just breathe fire on this dude now. Or just have Fa, you know. But actually, no. Oh well, actually, come to think of it, this guy does 41 damage. So we'll easily survive a turn of that. Should we just give the kill to Fa? Just for fun? Because he's going to attack either Shin or Klein, and he's not going to be able to kill them. So, we can actually give the kill to Fa. She should be able to take him out with some help. You know, just to see her gain shit tons of levels. I guess, Lou, you're kind of the reinforcement killer, I guess. Yeah, I'm just going to put you here on the throne, so you get some avoid. Da, 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 da. Yeah, that's what I thought he'd do. Rawr. To give us some breath mints. Because you see his like breath is bad. Get it? No. Okay, sorry. So, if we give this guy... Ooh, this will be perfect, actually. Unless Klein crits, which he very well may decide to do right now. Oh, good one, Klein. There we go. Ha! Go kill him. Oh, this is scary. 1% chance to die. Let's take it. Oh, I remember that form. Oh my god, it's a crit actually. Wow. My Fa is like, look at that fluffy little dragon. It's so cute. Yeah, and this is Fa's growth. Well, they weren't that good this time actually around, but usually she levels everything. As you can see, her base stats are pretty crap, but then again, she gets like god-like bonuses from her stone. I guess I'll heal you then. Oh, I almost used the Holy Maiden again. That would have been really embarrassing. Bigo, full health. Anyhow, let's just conquer the throne yet again. Not bad. Not bad at all. I wonder how far you will come. I want you to go on with your story. No matter how much we fought, you humans just seem to multiply endlessly. Eventually, we began to lose because of the humans' sheer number. Therefore, we created the Dark Dragon. And somehow I skipped that last bit. War Dragons. Dragons only meant for battle? That is correct. But the Divine Dragon did not agree with us. They said that would be defying the laws of nature. As we were discussing how we could persuade the Divine Dragons, they suddenly disappeared. Why? They most likely left us to prevent us from taking advantage of them. We could not find the Divine Dragons, but fortunately, we were able to capture one. And that became the Dark Dragon. Right. That Divine Dragon, Idun, was to become the Dark Dragon. However, she felt hesitation in letting the Divine Dragons and us other dragons go on to bad terms. Hesitation. Such nonsense is for humans only. We have no need of it. Then that hesitation worked against you. The Divine Dragon we captured was still young, but we had no problem because it was good enough for our purpose. However, its heart was not with us. It wouldn't follow our commands. So, you destroyed its heart? Exactly. We destroyed its soul to make it follow our every command. That's terrible. That is enough for now. If you want to know more, then you need to kill more dragons. Oh, we can do that. Oh, look, another one. They're increasing in levels, I think. Yeah, this guy's level 14 now. Maybe I shouldn't waste my divine weapons, but it's so much fun. Alright, I'll use a silver lance for now. Maybe I'll even use a silver blade. Yeah, I'll use a fucking silver blade. Just to be super nice. Power 14, actually the lance is much better. Silver lance is much better, actually. More hits, weighs less, same damage. Anyone need heals? Ah, you need heals, right? Yeah, I'm gonna use some mend stuff on you. Yeah. Oh, we can kill more dragons. Seems to be a lot of them these days. Yeah, we'll still use the Horror Blaze, I guess. Even though we probably shouldn't. Now, why is the Fire Tome effective against the Fire Dragon? I must ask. Shouldn't they theoretically be immune to this stuff? I guess it's magical. So a little... Oh. I was afraid I'd recorded all of this with my mic off. That would have been hilariously... hilarious, I guess. Yeah, that would have been an epic fail indeed. I just need to check that I actually got my microphone on. Nope, it all seems good. The only thing I actually noticed is that I need to take my microphone further away from my mouth, because... Yeah... I wasn't exactly impressed with the audio right there, but hey, what can you do about it? Well, I guess I could record everything over again, but to be quite honest, I don't want to do that. But I've turned the microphone a little bit away from my airy mouth, and so you shouldn't really have to hear any more of those things, you know. I'm just going to make sure I actually adjust it correctly this time. Okay, there we go. No. Silver sword, maybe? Yeah, those are odds I'll take. Even though it is a 5% chance that Alan will theoretically be gibbed. But then again, we gotta live on the edge a little bit, right? Luck! Okay, I'll take it. Let's see, 3 more dragons? Standing on the wall. Kill more dragons, kill and kill them all. Let's see. Yeah, you're kinda injured. We need to heal you. Recover! Oops. Yawn.
the last dragon. With chest hair.
Like his character. He's, there's actually a way to see him in Fire Emblem 7 as well, but I'm not going to spoil too much. I don't quite remember. Oh! There was a dragon hiding under the throne. I'm kind of glad I moved Luna out, to be quite honest. Wow, that was trolly, I must admit. Okay. I'm sorry, just had to adjust my microphone a little bit. Okay, so Lu is not the... Yeah, I'm actually really afraid now, because what if, like, a dragon comes out of this throne? Ugh. I'm gonna block the throne. No dragon coming out here. It's like, yeah, I order you to hide underneath the throne and come forth when the other guys have died. That's not how it works. Let's see, Ahmads. Oh, crap, your hit rating sucks. Well, let's gamble on our hitting. It's worked for us in the past. Ow. Ow, 6% crits. Come on. And I am disappointed. And it's actually super scary, come to think about it. Yeah, I think I'm going to rescue her now. Yeah, yeah, definitely going to do that. Fear, show her how it's done. Come on. Yes! That's how you do it. That's how you kill dragons. Ah, beautiful. Okay, so... Take... No, wait. That's not how we do it. Take... Release. And stand there. And use your cover staff. Now, doesn't Echinda actually have a lot of skill? It's kind of weird that she's missing so much. But I guess it's because that dragon was on a throne, which makes him considerably more dangerous. Considerably. Oh, so I guess they both are going to go for Shin now, are they? No matter. Shin will actually be able to take an attack from each one of them. But it's okay. He'll just lift his hoof and dodge the dragon fire. You know, horses really should panic in this place. Would be really cool if they had to, like, dismount. Actually, no, I never liked the dismount feature. It can go to hell. Actually, I kind of did like it. I don't really know. I have torn feelings about the dismount feature. That was, if you remember, Fire Emblem 3 actually allowed you to dismount. Not sure about Fire Emblem 5, if that also had that, but not to my knowledge, anyway. Yeah, if we can soften up this guy, then, yeah, so might as well use my last silver bow. Then I'm planning on giving Fa a kill again, you see. Honestly, it shouldn't be that hard to just fix it, but I'm not gonna be a... I'm not gonna be that kind of guy who tries to bring logic into this. Now, Armats will naturally kill this guy, but if I use a killer axe, then maybe she'll get a crit or two, and... Oh, come on, crit Echinda, crit. Actually, that guy crit Echinda, that's not cool. That's not cool at all. Now, how much damage does Fa do to these guys? Let's see, she has an attack of 31, actually. That's insane. Yeah, that is actually a one-shot. Hello! I'm the Pillow Dragon. It would actually be really amazing to have Lalum here right now. She's pretty much gonna level up once for every dragon she kills. Shoop! And then it's Klein. Guess you can do a number on this guy. Whoop. And whoop. Oh, my divine weapon is gone. Oh. Such a huge difference between silver bows and the Myrgre. Yeah, might as well do this, even though it pains me to do so. I'm gonna tickle your nostrils with a few lightning bolts, if you don't mind. Hopefully, I should be able to kill this guy with Roy now. though I don't think so, actually. I think Roy won't be able to do it, so... But Fear, with the Voodoo, should be able to. Not kill him, that is, but weaken him enough, because I figured she would get two crits.
Yeah, there we go.
Pew! There we go, now Roy should be able to finish the deal. Let's see, we have this temple, and this temple, and this temple, and this temple left. Dragon, where should I stick it to hurt it?
Right there.
See, that's how we kill dragons. And Roy gets like no XP at this point. Pick up Fa. Oh, finally! Still thinking, Master Roy. You know about that question I asked you like 20 chapters ago. Yes, I can't think of a good plan yet, but not your plan, okay? Yes, I understand, Master Roy. I mean, we can't use his plan anymore because Lance is dead. Or was Lance part of his plan? I don't really remember. But if there's anything I can do, please tell me. Yes, I will. Master Roy? I honestly still can't decide whether there is such a thing as a true victory. But if you believe it, then I will support you with all my strength. I give you lots of crit and damage. Thanks, Alan. I'm sure there will come a day when you'll understand. Then I shall look forward to that day. Oh, boring support is boring. But still, a support is cool. And Lou? He's probably gonna get surprised by another dragon now. Oh no, it's... I had two dragons hiding under there. Oh well. I'm not gonna wait for that guy, honestly. Instead, I'm going to conquer this throne. You have taken another step toward, but the way is still long. We shall still reach you. You have a stout heart. What do you wish to hear next? The story about how I visited my grandmother, perhaps? You succeeded in creating the Dark Dragon. The Dark Dragon pursues war dragons. Then why did you lose to the humans? Indeed, the Dark Dragon continued to produce war dragons to use in the battlefield. We were able to turn the tables on the humans. However, the humans soon found out about the Dark Dragon. They concluded that their numbers would not be enough to defeat us. Therefore, they put their efforts into constructing powerful weapons that would pierce our scales. They are what you call the Divine Weapons. That part is the same as our legends. The most powerful and potent were chosen out of the humans to wield their newly crafted weapons. They came and charged this temple. However, when their immense power of the weapons and our powers clashed near Burn, something unexpected happened. What happened? The laws of nature suddenly started to collapse. Snow began to fall midsummer. Stars shone in the middle of the day. Is that the ending winter? I heard that happened because you dragons unleashed too much power into the world. Is that how your legends go? The power in the divine weapons were used to restore order in nature. That's what our legends say. All the bad things that happened are all our fault. I would have expected you humans to think like that. But the truth is what I said. Then the divine weapons were sealed away as to not let such a disaster happen again? Then all those traps that protected them were to warn us. You sealed them away? That was a good decision. But they seem to be in your hands right now. Do not worry. The weapons do not seem to have as much power as they did in the past. They are unable to bring about a disaster again. The great disaster hurt us dragons greatly. How? The disaster was originally the reasons why we lost to the humans. I shall continue when you kill more dragons.
Okay.
Gotcha. This guy is still level 14, actually. Oh well. If I do some damage to this guy, maybe Alan can finish him off with the Malte. Ah! Beautiful Shin. That should be enough, I think. Oh, Shin is level 20 now. Right. And Malte time. And down you go.
guess you guys can come as well.
I actually want to kill more dragons with Fa. Couldn't think of it. That's really fun. I like that. And Master Roy, get on Clarine's horse. Her horse is amazing. But oh, hello. They sure like hiding dragons under chairs. Well, I still have four plays, so as long as I got that, your tactic will not work. Though Lou will not survive more than one dragon. I think I only have 2 4 blaze tomes left. Or uses, I should say. It's only one tome. It's not like I'm carrying around 40 tomes. Yeah, this guy's also gonna attack. Rawr. Ah, you missed. Failed dragon. Okay. And then we have this dragon. The Tron dragons doesn't move. That's fine. Oh, she needs heals. Klein, go here. And Shin, you can stay here. Yeah, she needs healing. Who shall we heal her with? Ellen. We also need someone to heal Lou, actually, because he's about to die if he uncovers another dragon beneath the chair. But, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and just one for good measure. This should be actually be a very safe spot. But I'm not certain at all. Hey, it's a nice spot for Alan. And I guess we can have it Shinda go here. Killing Edge or Killing Axe? Killer Axe is more fun, let's use that. If I go up here, then I should be able to fist it. Clarine, your magic. Ugh, I have no words. Seriously, your magic is so terrible. Now, what is physics again? Is it like 15 plus magic? It's not enough to save Lou, if should he get attacked. It's kind of sad.
Hey, wait for me, guys!
Why don't you just turn into a dragon and fly? You guys have wings for a reason, right? Come on, can you crit him? Nope. Actually, it's super scary to attack dragons with that shit. 4% chance of dying. Ah, look, a dragon for you. We prepared him well. Just gonna soften him up a little bit more so you can go kill him. I think that will do the trick. She does about 40 dragons to them. 40 dragon damage. 40 damage.
La 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 la. I'm a cute.
Oosh. Maybe she can kill that other dragon as well. And skill, luck, and defense. Cool. Let's see, we could probably use like tomes against this guy. Like javelins?
Actually, that takes way too long.
And that guy is just gonna heal for the show anyway. So what I propose is that people just start moving around here. You know, just move for the next temple. And to be quite honest, Shin, you can go pick up Blue, because he's kinda low. There we go. Rescue. Oh, hello. That was a surprise. You know, that trap is kind of getting old now. I'm kind of starting to think the reason why you lost the war is because you're fucking stupid. Yep. Drop off Lou. Mend. Yes, we need to mend Shin. He's damaged. So is Lou. Let's see. That's not good at all, actually. 72% chance to hit is not ideal. So I guess it's Durandal time again. Wow. go. The drone just gives a little bit too much evade. Down he goes. I'm just gonna move the other guys. I actually need to heal. Heal you as well, because you're pretty low.
Wow, wow.
Yeah, you can stay there. I guess you can pick up Fa and move. And it's time to have another chat with Jan. You've come here again. You're doing better than I expected. Please continue the story. Roy's just interested in the storytelling. When the orders of nature collapsed, we dragons took a fatal blow. The forces of nature weakened, and it became difficult for us to retain our original dragon form. Therefore, we decided to seal our powers in gemstones, take the human form instead. Those must be the dragon stones. Yes, now we were utterly powerless against the humans. In human form, we were just as weak. No, even weaker than the humans. The humans took advantage of our handicap and started attacking the dragons that had taken human form. Why did you take human form? In the new order of nature, the human was the form that required the least energy to transform into. The eight heroes mercilessly crushed us, helpless in our human form. I too suffered a deep wound. Do you have hate for the humans who wounded you? Hate? Only humans have such ridiculous emotions. We battled to maintain our species, and we lost. That is all. However, you humans might lose this time. Some human named Cephiel brought the Dark Dragon back to life again. Then Cephiel did break the Dark Dragon seal. That is correct. If you want to hear more, then show me some of your worthiness. Yeah, we all know what Jan wants you to do. Crap, there's a dragon there. Where did he come from? Oh, snap. Hello. I'm just waiting for that crit. It's going to happen. It's going to happen one day. Okay, I wonder what's in the next temple. Could it possibly be more dragons? Oh my! Level 15 this time. Well, we can manage somehow. But I actually think it's time to pull out the good old armets. But first, we need to recover you up. I don't think there's any member of the army that can actually survive more than two dragon attacks. Well, maybe Gonzalez would, but he's not here anymore because he fucking died against the Nomad. Go! Boosh! Oh, that was a one-shot actually. Perfect. There we go. Anyone need healing? I guess you do. You need healing. We're gonna be smart and we're gonna do like this. Oh, I don't have the Tina staff anymore. That's so sad. And I guess you can be Roy's transport. Zoop. Oh wait, Lou, you were damaged. Let's see. Mend. You don't know what dragon might pop up from under the chair. I seem to be doing it a few turns after I conquer the throne, though. Let's see, Alan, you can drop her off. Oh crap. No, wait, we're good. Okay. Fuck those dragons. You're too slow. I'm not bothering with you. Let's see. What if we send Alan up here? If I use the Silver Lance, that guy should have enough coming for him later. Let's see. Killing Edge, maybe? Yeah. Let's use the Killing Edge. I like the Killing Edge. Fa, you can stand here, ready to pick up some kills. I do wonder if Far has like a special dialogue with the last boss. I don't think he does, to be quite honest, or if she does, I should rather say. Well, look, more dragons. Now, one question though. When they were attacked by the eight heroes in their, what do you call them, like, human form, why couldn't the dragons just change back? They can now, or maybe they weren't able to back then. So basically, the tale that we made up that was like, oh, we like fought heroically against dragons, kind of like we are doing now, was nothing more than a cover-up plot for, you know, us actually defeating defenseless poor dragons, I guess. Yeah. Armads. I have armads. Your argument is invalid. Oh, whoop. I wonder if Etchina's gonna level up. Isn't she like level 19? No, she's actually level 18. Some more recover. Nah, but maybe we can kill that other dragon with Alan. That would have been nice. Or, you know, with, Fear! No, Fa! Fear. Fa. Fa, 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 fa. I'll even use Roy as bait. I think he does more damage than Alan, actually. Now he has one less strength. Oh, I've been singing on this song for a lot this episode, but it's such a nice song. Yeah, it's actually going to attack Roy. Oh well. Not today. And that should actually be enough for Fa to finish that thing off. Level 15. Nice, nice. I don't think Roy's gonna reach level 20, but he's already, like, way exceeded my expectations of him. This is actually this is a very good Roy right here. Not RNG abused in any way. And yeah, this is a dead dragon. It's like, she's whistling at them. Yet again, she gets like 100 experience from killing these guys. Strength, skill, luck, and resistance. Not bad. Who should I use to kill this guy? Yeah, it's the Durandal. Just gonna make sure Fear isn't damaged. Oh, could you crit Fear? That would have been so nice of you. Here we go. Only two temples remaining. So, this chapter isn't exactly what I would call hard, but then again, it is the last chapter of a Fire Emblem game, and they never really tend to be that hard. They're more like storytelling, epicness kind of chapters, but actually the last chapter of Fire Emblem 7 is kind of hard, if I remember correctly. But nevertheless, let's go on. I'm excited to see the final boss. Alan, you can go here. And Klein, not really using you much, but hey, you should be happy that you're even coming along.
Come on, if we continue to use the same tactic, maybe they'll fall for it.
I think it's like the dark dragon just birthing new humans. Or, I mean, sorry, new dragons. Like, bloop, here comes another one. Yeah, let's go conquer the throne. Conquer the throne, actually. Jan, I know you're there. It seems that you did indeed defeat Zephiel. Well, yes, we did. You might make it far enough to be able to fight me. What relation did the Dark Dragon have to Zephiel? You know that the founder of Burn is the Heartmage, the leader of the Eight Heroes, do you not? I know that. Then did you know that Heartmage didn't kill the Dark Dragon, but only sealed it away? I know, but I still don't know why he did that. I see. The Eight Heroes eventually defeated our leader, a
and they made their way to deep into the temple to find the Dark Dragon. However, when they arrived at the Dark Dragon's chamber, all they saw was a human girl looking off into space. It was Idun. They didn't fight. The Dark Dragon had its soul destroyed to follow our leader's commands. Since our leader had been killed, there were no further commands to follow. Then what happened to the Dark Dragon? The eight heroes naturally hesitated. They had expected to see the most powerful dragon, but all they saw was a girl who wouldn't respond even if spoken to. But the Dark Dragon still must be defeated, so the eight heroes prepared for battle. The girl must then have reacted to their attack. She changed into the Dark Dragon and fought back, just like the War Dragons, who had no hearts. Hartwood then used the blade stronger than the divine weapons and slashed at the Dark Dragon's scales. The Sword of Seals? I don't know why what you humans call it, but that must be it. Anyway, when the sword cut through the Dark Dragon's flesh, it suddenly fell unconscious. It didn't die? Yes, apparently the sword reacted to its wielder's feelings, and changed its power accordingly. So Hartwood didn't want to kill it, so the Sword of Seals reacted to his emotion, and only knocked the Dark Dragon unconscious. I understand that Hartwood did know a little bit about the Dark Dragon, and then seeing her as the little girl Idun, he must have felt pity for her. It is another emotion that we dragons cannot comprehend. Pity? And thus, at the bottom of his heart, he didn't want to kill her. In my opinion, it would never have something that would... I would never leave something that would be a danger to me alive. So Hartwood's heart changed the sword's strength. Hartwood persuaded his comrades and decided to seal the Dark Dragon. He built a temple deep in the forest of Burn and sealed Idun away, using the sword and a gemstone. They are what you call the Sword of Seals and the Fire Emblem. Oh, so here the Fire Emblem comes into the plot. He then created a nation near the temple that would watch over and protect the seal from being broken. They are the ancestors of Sephiel. How do you know all of this? Were you watching? No. I have been deeply wounded, so I was leading a hidden life, healing myself. I heard that the story about the seal from Sephiel. Although he said that he read it in the ancient scrolls that are kept in the court library. How did you meet Sephiel? With him? If you can reach me, I will tell you. It is not far now. Only one more temple. This guy is still level 15. Oh my god, all this dragon killing is making me really thirsty. Well, guess I'll have to kill a few more. Whew, okay, almost there now, guys. Almost there. Yeah, I'll use the malt on you. Sure, why not? Pa-pow! Dragon down. I'm actually really tired already. This Let's Play is wearing me down greatly. Okay, pick up Roy. Move Roy. Other guys. Stay on throne just for lols. And move this guy. Oh. Yeah, not gonna comment that anymore. Feel like I've done the joke to death. I guess I'll kill you two then. Oh my god, how many babies did that girl make? I wonder how she creates the dragons, to be quite honest. I probably don't want to know. If I Google it, I'm sure I'll find some disturbing pictures. Aw, Malta broke. That's kind of sad. That's the first divine weapon I break, I think. And it won't be the last. Armets will surely fall next. Yep, let's release Roy. Do we have any wounded guys here? Nope. Actually, Pa is kind of wounded. She's lost hit points from leveling so much. Naturally pointless, but hey, still want to do it. There we go. Move, move, move. Move the dudes.
Now that guy is going to attack Echinda. Oh my god, it's quite a lot of dragons behind us at this point. It's like a Benny Hill chasing thing. Oh shit. Well, they still can't one-shot Clarine. But it's darn close though. No, actually, she's going to level on the next one. Shall we level her up just for lulz? Maybe she'll level magic. Alright, let's do it. I'll do it. Fine. Just since you've been with me for the entire game. Okay, actually not the entire game. What chapter did she join in? Like chapter 4? I guess? It's something. She's been with me for quite some time. And of course, magic. You know, who needs that, right? No, I don't want to use Roy, actually. Let's use a halberd, because Echinda thinks this dragon is a horse. Well, it's bigger than the horse, so... Would be cool to get her up to level 20, actually. She almost gets as much XP as for hitting the dragon as she does for, like, killing it. And... Pew! Laser beams! This is amazing. Oh, she's such an overpowered character. Yep, that was like a... She seriously has a constitution of 1. Are you kidding me? 1? How much does this thing weigh? Okay, it actually doesn't weigh anything. Which I guess she takes no speed penalty either, but she has a speed of 5. That is terrible. Really weird. She's not gonna double anyone. Hello, Lou. Is that 4-blaze tome of you any good? Yeah, so you might have guessed at this point if you haven't completed this game yourself, but the reason why I have to keep the sealed sword... Well, I guess I'll tell you when the time comes. You might have a guess now, though, what I'm going to use it for. Aww. Second divine weapon down. Oh well. Guess everything has to come to an end, right? I'm actually gonna keep Alan here to pick up Roy. Conquer! You have come far. I am in the chamber right in front of you. It has been long since I last met humans in my true form. I have not left this place ever since the war. You were always here? 1,000 years. Having survived the scouring, I waited, healing my wounds in the process. I waited for the resurrection of the Dark Dragon that would bring hope to us dragons again. You mean us dragon, right? Because you're kind of the last one. And that time came. The Dark Dragon's seal was broken, and I felt power flowing through my veins again. How does the Dark Dragon's seal being broken make your strength recover? The Dragon Temple power depends on the Dark Dragon's, and thus the Divine Dragon's power. If the Dark Dragon were to be sealed, then there is no way I could have recovered to full strength by using this temple power. I see. After my strength fully recovered, I set out to look for the person who had broken the seal. I used my illusion to search him out and ask his intention. I did not wish to go outside in my true form, knowing that you humans now run the world. Wait, I thought the dragons in their human form lost most of their powers. Then how are you creating this illusion? This temple is for the dragons. It is the only place that dragons can use a little of their power, even in human form. I am a fairly powerful dragon, even in human form, as long as I stay in the temple. Creating illusions is easy. Still, I would not be able to create actual things like the Dark Dragon can. So, you found Cephiel? Right. I found Cephiel and asked him, why did you break the Dark Dragon's seal? Cephiel was an odd man. He didn't seem to be at least a bit surprised. He looked me right back into the eye and asked me who I was. After I told him that I was a dragon, he started to smile mysteriously. Then he said, my intentions are to give the world to your kind. I cannot say that I fully trusted him,
but he was still the Dark Dragon's new master, so I decided to work with him. Cephiel then ordered the Dark Dragon to leave the world in place of foolish humans. But Cephiel is dead. What is the Dark Dragon doing now? Although he's gone, the Dark Dragon resides in the chamber behind me. She's waiting for the chance to free the world. But her master is gone. Are you her new master? I did not need to become her master. She was commanded to carry out Cephiel's order, even if he were to die. Idun has absolute obedience to her master. She will make sure that humans are banished from this land. What? Her heart was destroyed and now she's bound to orders given by a person long dead? Do you feel pity, like Hogmut did? You humans are truly difficult to understand. But let me tell you this. No matter how hard you try, humans and dragons will never be able to live in harmony. The gap between species is impossible to fill. That's not true. I know a place where dragons and humans are living together. Dragons and humans were both brought into the same world. They can and will understand each other. Dragons and humans living together in harmony? Rubbish. I have no intention of listening to such nonsense. Now enter my domain. Let us see who has more power.
Oh. More dragons. This is getting tiresome.
Yes, yes. Tap, 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 tap. Tap, 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 tap.
Oh my.
Sure, a lot of dragons here. Okay. No, thank you.
Whew, okay.
So, here's Jan. He's level 18. And his stats are pretty decent. However, he's not able to attack from a range. Which is pretty much why he sucks. Okay, what I could do actually. I could use my... I have three warp staffs left actually, come to think of it. Maybe I should warp up some guys, I don't know. I could, but I'm just gonna equip the steel blade. Last temple remaining. There we go. And I wonder if they hit dragons underneath this one as well. Yes, they did. I'm gonna hold set in, because I don't want to watch all those dragons moving. There we go. Oh, wow. That was a really quick dragon. Ow. And, oh, a catapult horse would be pretty cool at this point. Okay. Alan. It's time to level up that light magic of yours. Would be nice to actually use the Aurora. Aurelia. See? Oh, Clarine, it's healing actually. So does Etchi. Heal them up. We can't have them at low health when they're fighting dragons. That would be really terrible. So, let's see. You know, I could kill this dude with far, I guess. I don't want those guys to like bite me in the ass, so I'm going to be equipping the Killing Edge. I might as well have these guys to deal with the dragons. Actually, I'm gonna pull them back because there might be dragons coming out of that throne room. That would be terrible, actually. Yeah, like that. Yeah, there will be a dragon coming out of that throne room, actually. The next turn, if I'm not mistaken. So, I might place Shin on the throne, actually, just to avoid that. Oh! Pow, 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 pow! And again! There we go. Moving dragons. Whew. Okay, Etchinda. Pull forth your armaments. heal up Corrine as well. Though, yeah. Suppose there's little point, she's not going to be taking any more damage. But then again, you know me, I always like to have my dudes at full hit points. Let's see, Shin, I kind of want you on this round, because dragons are coming, and that would kind of be... Actually, I don't really want people near these guys. I actually just want to run, come to think of it. This is... Why did I do this? Oh, crap. Let's just avoid 99. Oh, Shin. Because I think that a dragon will actually... Oh, fucking hell, no. Oh, wait a minute. It's movement of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No! 1, 2, 3, 4. Bloody hell. I think if Fa dies, I'm actually forced to restart the level. So I am actually just going to lose fear now. Stupid as I am. Oh, there wasn't a guy coming out this time. Yeah, this is... I might lose fear now. Oh, he actually see, he goes for Shin. Oh no, one hit point. Come on. Oh.
Not here. I've come so far.
Yes, it's true, actually. You did reach the final level. Oh my god, I lost Shin. My god, was that stupid? And I could have just pulled. Ah, that's so depressing. I was kind of hoping to get them all through this chapter. Ugh. Stupid, stupid Manx. Oh well, he died an honorable death. Now fear has no friends either. Oh, I was reckless. Should never have moved all my units and then proceeded to, like, hey, let's kill dragons. We don't need to kill, just for lulz. Sorry, I don't really have any patience to watch all your movement animations. But now we can turn it off. Oh well, it's not like I needed Shin anyway, but still. It's always nice to have more people survive. So we can read their endings, because there's going to be like... What happened to them after the game kind of stuff at the end, and kind of like reading that. But if they die, it's just going to says, died, and that's really sad. Okay. Hey, dragon. Oh well, actually, without four blaze, we aren't killing that thing so easily. Pew pew! Oh, my throat is so dry. I cannot wait to actually be able to have a drink. Echinda kinda needs healing, I suppose? Oh, no damage to Yon. Ah, it's terrible. Yeah, please just heal up Echi. I might actually use her against Yon, because he has quite a buttload of hit points, and I'm almost out of legendaries. And that is not cool at all. I might actually need fear for this. Oh. Well, Klein, I guess you get some fighting. The terms of dodging Dragon Flame. That was quite impressive, actually. 80% hit, and you dodge it. Oh, okay. It's time. Actually, it's not time yet. We need to go kill Yon first. No, I need to kill this guy first. I guess Lou can do that? Ah, perfect. Lean kill. Oh. Oh, okay. Ellen. And we have a special battle music. I personally love this track. I think it's one of the best boss musics in Fire Emblem. 1,000 years. My strength has long recovered. I can feel it. Well, he looks just like all the other dragons, but hey. Yeah, Echi, it's your time to shine. If you can even hit the guy, though. They could have given him, like, a custom sprites. You know, he's, like, supposed to be the true dragon and all that shit. Can we kill them with Far? That would be hilarious, actually. Ah, no, I'm not gonna bother. Derp. Silver Lance does nothing. How about Silver Bow? No? Killer Bow? No? This guy is very beefy. He should be dead next turn, though, if Etchinda lands a couple of hits. Unless he uses an elixir, though, that could actually be quite a pain in the ass if he did that. Careful of Far. And of course, just, yeah, he has no ranged attack. He kinda has no choice on who to fight. Come on, kick his ass. Kick his ass, come on. Ah. Need to kill him before the dragon catches up. There is a shit ton of dragons coming for me. Ah. Okay. We have two spellcasters though, in the form of Alan and Lou. They should be able to finish this guy. Oh, if you leveled your light magic to S rank now. Oh, I'm going. You know what? Screw this. I am killing him with the new light tome I've obtained. Ellen's gonna get the honor of using, like, the divine weapon I still have 20 uses left on against this guy. Because it has a really cool animation. Alright, closing in on us. And there we go, shit ton of dragons. What level are these guys anyway? Level 12. They're all level, okay, some of them are level 14. That's fine. Actually, ooh, I almost ended the turn. Nah. You know, we'll finish with style. Laser beam of lights. Oh, that was a kill.
So I have lost. Humans are truly unpredictable.
Yep, all those 1,000 years were kind of pointless, yeah.
In the next chamber lies the Dark Dragon.
Roy!
What's wrong, Fa? You look about to burst into tears.
Is Fa also an enemy?
Huh?
When Fa gets big, will Fa become a bad dragon too?
Oh, you're so cute.
Wait, Fa. Tell me what you want to say, slowly.
The man said so. Dragons and people can't live together.
But you were living in that bottle with other people, weren't you?
But the Dark Dragon is a divine dragon like Fa is. And you're going to fight the Dark Dragon, right? What about Fa? As Fa grows up,
if Fa grows up, and becomes like the Dark Dragon, then you don't have to worry about that. Even though you grow up, you'll always be Fa. You'll always live together with humans, and with us.
Really?
Sure. And also, I actually want to help the Dark Dragon.
Help?
The Dark Dragon is not acting on her own will. She had her soul destroyed. I don't want to kill her if I can avoid it.
Fa doesn't get it.
You'll understand when you get a little older. Hartmut possessed a question. Pose the question, and I'll give an answer to it.
Okay, this wasn't actually not the last chapter.
This is the last chapter. Final. Beyond the darkness.
There she is. You're the Dark Priestess. No, the Dark Dragon.
Why do you hinder my path?
What?
I have been commanded to lead this world. I shall make the world a better place. Why are you barring my performance?
You are wrong.
You were only told the world would become a better place. The person who ordered you is already dead. So stop. You no longer have any reason to fight. You, no, we have no reason to fight. A long time ago, I heard those same words. Soft words, like a warm breeze. But that was long ago. I have been asleep for too long. In the darkness, I was dreaming, an empty dream, white, colorless. But now I am awake. His Majesty willed me so. Majesty Zephiel? I have woken. I am no longer who I used to be. I now clearly understand what I must do. I must lead this world, no matter how many days or nights pass. I must. You insist on fighting us. As long as you stand in my path. Such strong will. His Majesty wishes it to be. And I was woken to answer His Majesty's calls. Now what else did he ask you to do, Aiden? Just... oh crap. Do we have to fight? I will win. This is the end. We mustn't lose now.
This is the end. Finally it will end.
I won't lose. I can defend us all.
Well, you probably can. I will protect someone with my life. Probably Roy.
The long battle is about to end. Saint Elamine, give us strength.
Now, too bad we didn't get to hear Shin's battle quotes, because he kinda died.
I will not give up.
I had the Sword of Heartmatch who pitted you and did not kill you. Everyone, leave the final blow to me.
So, yeah.
Final boss time! And, well... she isn't actually the most difficult final boss of all time, let's just be honest right here. She's kinda terrible. Because... basically, you have two choices. You can either kill her with a normal unit, or you can seal her away, and we are going to seal her away, because I've personally never done that before. So, Roy, go get her. Everyone stay back. Let Roy handle this. Good day, Aiden. Oh, snap. Phew! Sealed away. Oh, maybe that was killing her. Well,
I... alone, dark. Alone in the darkness.
That was a very scary video game, I remember that.
Down she goes.
So guys, that was like kind of the final boss of the game. I know. She's ridiculously easy if you have the sealed sword, but I guess she's not like supposed to be super hard.
Ah! What's happening? The temple is starting to collapse. Everyone hurry outside! Roy!
I know. Leave the rest to me. Now go.
He took her and he turned her green.
Master Roy, you are alright.
Yes, but the temple is gone.
So it's over 1,000 years old, and a lot of energy was released in the battle you just fought. The building probably couldn't withstand it.
I see.
So times are changing again, and...
who is that you're carrying on your back?
Her? Oh, alright. Yeah, she's kind of just a dark dragon that wanted to destroy everyone. Kind of thought I'd bring her home.
Marlinus, I need to ask something of you.
And we get the ending in Japanese! You know, that was kind of a translation fail. I mean, you'd kind of want to translate this part, right? So, basically, I suppose, the Dark Dragon was brought home, and then he turned into a dark dragon and killed everyone. No, I'm just joking. So, it's like everyone's happy again, I suppose. I wish I could read Japanese. My friend actually knows a little bit of Japanese. He could probably translate this. But, it is happy ending.
But will it be? Dot, dot, dot.
I'm pretty sure that's what it is. It's like, for now.
Oh, there's more. Princess Guinevere, congratulations on your crowning.
Yes, but my battle is only about to begin.
I'm sorry. I had to rely on Etruria to fulfill my task.
No, I am grateful.
However, I think that there will be people who think that I joined Etruria just to seize the throne.
Princess, but the most important thing now is to rebuild Bern.
I will try my best and gain the people's trust by bringing Bern back to life. No matter how long it takes. If there is anything I can do to help, please don't hesitate to ask.
You know, if you want any more heirs or something like that, you know.
Thank you. Someday I might.
Roy, are you...
Yes?
What are you going to do? Will you remain in the Etrurian army?
No, I will return to Farah. I'm worried about my father's illness, and we have to start rebuilding the lands that were trampled by the war.
You are returning to your homeland. That is just like you. Still, someone of your ability could easily aim for higher power in the Turing court, you know.
Like my husband, maybe? Wink, wink.
Me? No, no, no. I have no such ability. Farah's people are fortunate to have such a gifted leader as you.
Oh, look, it's Captain Obvious. Princess, I mean, your majesty.
Guinevere is fine. What's the matter?
Yes, Lady Guinevere, the ceremony is about to begin.
Thank you. I will be there shortly.
Roy, will you come with me?
Me?
Ever since I left Bern with the Fire Emblem, you have helped me tremendously. I want you to see the path Bern will take with my leadership.
Oh, of course. If it's alright with you, then I'll be glad to accompany you.
Then, let us go see a new Bern and a new age.
Oh, Roy, that's not what she wanted you to come along for.
Later in Arcadia. Ah, yeah, this is what you get if you seal her away, I think.
Ah, Master Roy, it has been a long time.
I had business in these areas, so I decided to stop by on the way.
You decided to stop by and dress up, okay.
Fa will be glad to see you. I saw her earlier. She is as energetic as ever.
She's being allowed outside more these days. Perhaps that is why.
How is the girl I sent her doing?
We succeeded in restoring her soul, but she still won't go back to normal. Fa sometimes takes her outside, but she won't try to do anything on her own.
I see. Master Roy, we knew that the girl you sent her was captured by the dragons.
Still, we did not try and rescue her. We feared that our kind would be in danger if we showed ourselves in front of them again. But now, I wonder whether my judgment was correct.
Perhaps it is because we have begun to live with humans. I will make my best efforts to bring the girl's heart back fully.
Thank you. As a first, I would like to see some sign that her emotion is... Let's try that again. As a first, I would like to see some sign that her emotions are working, like laughing or crying, or something.
And this is what you call a tree.
Tree?
Right. And that tree gives yummy fruits.
Fruit?
Yes. Can you see? It's up at the top.
Oh, it's that tree I put a Chinda in to dodge that hero.
And if you shake the tree like this...
Ow! It fell on Fa's head.
Laughs.
Hmm?
Did you just laugh?
Aw.
Laugh? Oh, man, this dialogue is fucked up. Where's Roy? Fa has to tell Roy that Aiden laughed.
No, she's running around Aiden. Like a little dog.
warm breeze.
I'm just sitting here smiling. I love this game.
Now, I guess we'll see how long we spend to finish the different chapters.
Ah, yeah, now we get the endings. Right.
Roy returned home to rebuild the lands in Lycia that were trampled by the war. Still, people always seemed to like him. He left behind many legends during the course of his life. Prince of Fair. Oh, right, we get some credits in between, I guess. That's a nice way to actually make us watch the credits.
Takafumi Kaneko.
Japanese names are so awesome. I wish I had a Japanese name. Light Memgets, Fa. After returning to Namata, Fa was never heard of again. Many historians today voice their skepticism whether she really existed at all.
Da-da. Art Director, Taiko Kaneda. We have Saichu Wada, Sashachiku Wada.
Everything sounds amazing in Japanese. I wonder what I would be named like.
Mangsuru Hestsuenru.
And Shin. Chapter 24 marked the end. Yeah, that was kinda where she died.
Takanuiri Hino.
Are we gonna see, like, all the people who I ever brought with me? Because there's a lot of dead dudes in that thing.
Chikara Yamamoto!
Oh, Yamamoto, I love that name. Fia Myrmidon. First set out again to travel around the world in training. Her name eventually spread through and the continent as the next sword saint, and her legends were to be told for centuries to come.
Naotaka Oshini. Otomu Chikashareshi.
Ah, I'm amused by this.
Maki Taekomokuniri Yoko Makai.
Makai, actually. I can't really understand if these are female or male names, but yeah, I guess they're mostly males.
Clarine the Troubadour. Clarine returned home to Aquilia and lived her life as she did before the war. Her personality never changed, but her charm and true kindness earned her admiration and love from her peers in the Etrurian nobility.
Sumiko Miki.
Death of the Ve'echidna.
That's a cool title. After Echidna went back home to the Western Isles, the people there were overjoyed at the return of their hero. Her hard work on the Western Isles into a new nation, the Western Union.
Ah. Yuka Chushiyoko.
Ah, I'm gonna stop reading these names now. They're getting too complicated for me.
Ah, Child of Anima, Lu.
Lu built a magic school where the orphanage used to be. He took in orphans and other deprived children and taught them magic as a way to live.
Ah, it's a cool ending.
Oh, there's a lot of people who made this game, I must say.
Da, 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 Alan, Fiery Knights.
Come on. Nothing? What? What happened to Alan? Oh, come on, don't be like that, translation patch. I guess he did nothing, then. A.G. Kaneda! Oh, it's this... Isn't that the same guy? I guess it just wants to show people twice. Or maybe different people just worked on multiple things.
Klein, the sniper!
Klein put down his bow and became an ambassador for Etruria. He used his diplomatic abilities to settle various foreign affairs. And while he was in office, he made sure that Etruria was the center of a prosperous continent.
Inver's priest there, Ellen.
Ellen returned to Burr with Guinevere to rebuild a land ravaged by war, and to reunite a people devastated by defeats. Her hard work and kind-hearted nature earned her the title the Saint of Burn.
Special thanks.
Whew. Wow, I am utterly spent. This has been a fucking long let's play, guys. I guess I should kinda say some last words now, shouldn't I? Well, it's been over 35 hours of content, I suppose. Thank you for everyone who has commented on my video. Thank you for everyone who's been watching it. I'm sure a lot of people will continue to watch it as they notice it. I do plan to make a lot more Let's Play content. This has been my very first Let's Play. I've never done a Let's Play before this one, and it started off sort of like a hobby project. I never really thought I'd finish it at all. Special thank you must go out to Mr. NTN, which of course I must be pronouncing horribly wrong. Thank you for your hilarious comments that always pointed out my mistakes. I've actually learned a lot from you, and it's been a big inspiration all the way. Thank you to Tyrannar, I guess Cyril, who was supposed to make more Let's Play content. What the hell are you doing, man? And, yeah, thank you for everyone else who's been commenting, and, it's been really, really, really fun. I've been enjoying this, the hell out of this, really. And this definitely will not be the last one. Not gonna make too many promises, though. It's been quite a journey. And now, I think I will retire and have a long night of sleep. Okay, first we will have to watch how far, how long I used to complete these damn chapters. Wow. 45 turns, 37, 30, 23, 35, 42. There's actually, I think, to the right of it is actually the in-game time I spent. Could it, no, could it seriously be that? Did I really spend 2 hours? Are you kidding me? Wow, 60 turns. How the hell did I spend 60 turns? And 11, 10, 13, 18, 12, 11, 21, 30, 45 turns! Wow, that's a lot of turns. And one turn, and the final one. Oh. Do I get like a ranking now? Oh yeah, I do. E, okay, C on tactics, B on survival, E on XP, C on weapons, C on time, and C on funds. And overall, I get a C rank. And I've in total spent 36 hours playing this game. Holy shit, that's a long time. Oh, we actually get the other units as well. Rose to the top of the Etrurian military. Okay, Lalum died, I guess. We get the other guys as well. Melody, yeah, she kinda died. Yodel,
also died. Man, I lost a lot of units. Astol, he also died. Nemeth died. How the hell did I get B in survival? Tate died. Balls didn't die. Work to rebuild Ostia. Okay. I guess you only get their cool and if you actually bring them to the final mission. I got Saul as well. And Lance. Both died. Almost at the same time. Kath traveled the world as a thief. And OJ traveled as a mercenary. And we have Thaney, returned home and was knighted. Worked to rebuild Ostia. Elegant lord, actually. That's kind of cool. Marcus enjoyed retired life. I'm sure you did, buddy. And Sue continued to live in Sase. Ah, Noah. Set out to test his strength. Lotch returned home and lived happily with 8 strength. Rutger disappeared like the wind. That's kind of what happened in my Let's Play. Chad spread the word of Elamine, worked to help orphans. Or others, I'm not sure. Dorothy, ugly archer, returned home to her old life. Yeah, Volt kinda died in chapter 4. Holy shit, that was early. Ward, helped develop the Western Isle. Oh, Dick, don't get me fucking started about Dick. Saul became a wandering missionary. And Celot helped rebuild Illa. Wendy lived life as an Armonite, and Barth rebuilt the divided Ostian army. Jees reopened his trade routes, and Cecilia worked to rebuild Etruria. And Sophia returned to Nabata. And Green also returned to Nabata, and then vanished. Zeiss helped Guinevere rebuild Bern, and Douglas retired and lived peacefully. Dian reunited his former clansmen, and Carl retired to a village in Bern. Finished! Yes, we are done. Alright, my name has been Mangs. Thank you for watching my Let's Play. It's been a blast. I'm sure I'll see you again soon.